quench our thirst and offer refreshment at the well of your wisdom. But will we drink in all you offer? O God, grant us the wisdom and courage to go where you lead, regardless of our reticence. Help us to journey forward even when we are frightened or uncertain, even when the path is unclear. Shine into the dim-lit corners of our hearts and our faith, so we may move out of the shadows of the tomb ever closer to the peace and promise of Easter. And when anger and adversity call us closer, when bitterness and offense lead us away from you, carry us back, so we may follow in your footsteps again and again. And when I am led to an alternative route, one unplanned and unpredicted, grant me the insight to trudge forward, always trusting in your guidance, always believing in your grace, remembering that joy will be found when I follow your lead. Today, we remember those who are suffering, who are unclear and frightened by the road ahead. And in our own community, we pray. We pray for Wendy and her mother recovering from a car accident, for Suzanne on the loss of her partner's mother, for Bill and Betsy on the loss of their son, for Irma and Josh and Ani and Barry and Marilyn, Chandra and Bob and Elizabeth, and for all the other concerns that weigh on our minds. We know you hear us, God, and we know you will guide. And in the silence, we listen. Give thanks for this desert distraction, this time as we continue to work on building our new church. We give thanks for this beautiful place, for all of the gifts that you have given us and the way that you have led us. And as we journey forward, may we always be a blessing to those we encounter. In this we pray. I invite us now to join together in the prayer that Francis of Assisi taught us. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace.